Isis in the Bible, summer gathering week number 8, celestial spring? The question for today is, what sign will the full moon and eclipse be in? When we read, watch, listen to someone else's viewpoint, do you ever question the answers? Do we walk in blind faith or do we look for the answers? At the end of the day, does it really matter? Well, yes, it does if you want the best out of your infinite lives. Much is upon us that is written in the Bible, which stems from the Egyptian walls and texts. You are infinite. Get over it. So we went around the room and we got the poll. We got a few abstains. And we got 5 in Aries, 4 in Pisces. The full moon, that's what the vote is. The full moon from everybody around the room said 5 in Aries, 4 in Pisces. And one of the person that said Pisces, they actually went and looked outside at the moon where it was traveling and did a little projection to say, what's actually happening in the sky, it's Pisces. So what's happening in the sky? Let's look into the future, shall we? Well, we're coming upon this full moon on September 29th, 2023. Where is it? And what about the eclipse on October the 14th? What is the whole world telling you? Why is there a correlation with the events around the world like never before seen and what is happening in the stars? Most everyone around the world is telling you the full moon is in Aries. Let's go see, shall we? So on September 29th, full moon. As you can see, the sun is in Virgo. And opposite, the full moon on 29th, the moon is in Pisces. This is using what's actually happening in the sky. Right? And then on October the 14th, 2023, the eclipse. You can see the sun with the moon is going to be near the harvest line before Spica. This is significant. These events are all happening around the cross. And just from time and date, you can see the path of the eclipse, which is basically between North and South America. So looking at stellarium, what's actually happening in the sky on September the 29th, you can see that the moon is in Pisces. It's not in Aries. We got to look to see what's happening in the sky, in the stars, or else we won't know when it's time to come home to one love. And then on October 14th, the eclipse. Stellarium has many settings, like there are many Bibles, like there are many languages, like there are many interpretations of the Egyptian walls. You got to use the Dendro Zodiac to know where the constellations go. So we wrote a routine so that we can show this is where Spica is. This is where you have to set your astrology app to in order to get the proper locations as per the Dendro Zodiac. Where Spica is the grain of wheat, which sits right here at harvest. So this is the end of Virgo, beginning of Libra. And as you can see, as we spoke about, what's actually happening in the sky for the eclipse on the 14th. It's in the end stages of Virgo. For those of you having some intestinal problems, some digestive problems, the sun has been in Virgo. And the full moon will be in Virgo. Right? Across Pisces, Virgo, feet, intestines, Virgo. And also Virgo for the eclipse. So if you're like me and you have both sun and moon in both Virgo and Cancer, stomach and bowels, then you're really going to feel it. So I'm already going through one with Hygieia, both on my sun and my moon, going through a stomach and intestinal cleanse. Somebody asked the question, should we be fasting around this eclipse? And I would take it easy on the bowels 100%, especially if you're susceptible. So you got to use what's happening in the sky. You can't shine a flashlight next to your eyes and you won't blink. You shine a flashlight directly into your eyes, you will blink. All physics says you've got to look what's happening in the sky. So let's look at all the surrounding events. since the Corona chakra cleanse that we predicted back in May of 2019. We've seen that Eris was coming into the Corona on June 1st, 2019 for the first time in 558 years. Then we also spoke about April 15th, 2023, the Phoenix Rising, which was Revelation 12:1. This is happening all here, as you see in the Dendera Zodiac, at the zero arise. Aries is the same word as arise, is the same word as Alpha and Eris. You can see the waiting for enlightenment, so this happens. So this consciousness raising that we're going through isn't because of a virus, isn't because of a thing. Families aren't getting together, people aren't raising their consciousness because of a thing called a virus. It's a process. Virus is a snake spitting its poison. It's Eris, the goddess of discord and strife. It's not literal being, you're just being induced by love, your own love, per your karmic records. So then, this year, look at what's happening all on the cross. On October 14th, 2023, we have that solar eclipse, which we just showed you is happening right here in Virgo. October 17th and 18th, 2023, the sun meets with Mary and the snake. And you know that the south and north node is the cobra. And this is here, Mary and you, and saying, what have you done? After the weighing of the heart ceremony, the balance, there's Mercury. There's Spica right here. There's Sarah's the harvester, and there's Mary talking to you. So again, on April 15th, the sun on a meeting with the mother for her to see you, to see if you are ready for the Phoenix Rising. October 14th, there's an eclipse near the cross in the west to look to your soul. This is where resistance comes in. Muddy waters gets cleansed. October 17th and the 18th, the sun meets on the cross in the west and the snake. It truly is a deep induction of pure love. And of course, on October 28th, 2023, we have a lunar eclipse when Jupiter aligns with Mars. These are all biblical events. They're happening in the sky. The North Node is going to be in the seventh house. So Jupiter aligns with Mars, with the moon in the seventh house, just like the song. But get this, that partial lunar eclipse on that day, sign, everywhere a sign. And then on November 27th, on the cross, Mary steps on the snake, which is Genesis 3:15. We've showed you these in other videos. So please note that all this is happening on the cross. It's a calling. It's time for you to wake. You are the chosen one of your world. From Brother NEXT on YouTube, he got into the Temple of Isis. Not many have been able to film inside the Temple of Isis. You can see that all these messages we left on the Egyptian walls would tell us when pure love is going to cleanse our waters. Can you see the phoenix rising, the sun, the snakes, or the cobras of the north and south nodes? So you can see the sun, the phoenix rising, the rays, the black snake, the white snake. It's all there, folks. Two cobras make the north and south node, and those nodes are aligning with 0 degree Aries. Here's a synchronicity for you. Look at this image that's on that wall, in the walls in the Isis temple. They have Hathor and Nephthys, which is Venus and Juno. And what a synchronicity for today. We have Venus aligned with Juno. Coincidence? I don't think so. It's just more proof that we need to listen, tune into these vibrations. Let's talk about the spring rains we're upon. Do you remember the floods in southern Florida, right? Right around the Phoenix Rising? A historic flood occurred in Fort Lauderdale, Florida, and in the surrounding areas on April 12, 2023. So the rains are coming. In the book Kingship and the Gods, I was blessed to have this book given to me by Nicholas. They too talk about the rains, but know that they are not just a physical rain. It's a purple rain, the rain you cannot see. The thought that death is vanquished at the beginning of the new year survives in religions which originated in the Near East because it carries conviction through the harmony which it establishes between the visible and invisible worlds. A hymn of the Eastern Church contains the words, "The Almighty awakens the bodies at Epiphany together with the spirits And it is said that Christ writes our names in the book of life. In the Talmud, too, the raising of the dead is linked with the rainstorms, which in turn are connected with the new year. The book speaks of traditions in the Eastern Church, the Talmudic Judaism, and Islamic theology. In relation to the New Year's festival in Babylonia, the Eastern Church mentions the Epiphany in the Book of Life. Talmudic Judaism discusses of Rabbi Joseph's answer in the Three Keys of God. Babylonian beliefs discuss a New Year's festival, Marduk, and Netherworld. Islamic theology mention of rain coming down from heaven to germinate mankind. They all speak upon the interconnectedness of natural phenomena, rain and wind, with divine actions, resurrection, birth, mountains, and gates. We see it happening everywhere, and it's happening in the sky. As you can see on the Dendera zodiac, here we are in bondage from the Piscean age. We're in bondage of our karmic sins, sine waves, the waves we've left behind. Remember, you only feel what you've left behind, nobody else. And here is John the Baptist pouring the water, see the fish, over top of us. This is where we get the Jubilee. All your sins are forgiven. Your karmic waves are forgiven. So this is the rains that we're talking about. And these happen when we have all these biblical events happening on the cross, and we're upon it. Rain in the Bible. Hosea 6:3, let us acknowledge the ruling goddess. Let us press on to acknowledge her. As surely as the sun rises, she will appear, and she will come to us like the winter rains, like the spring rains that water the earth. She causes her sun to rise on the evil and the good. She sends rain on the righteous and the unrighteous. Job 28, established the force of wind and measured out the waters, made a decree for the rain and a path for the thunderstorm. So the thunderstorm comes towards you, the path, based on your karma. If it's all good, you're going to feel incredible. If there's some muddy waters, you know that it's coming your way. Zechariah, ask the ruling goddess for rain in the springtime. It is the ruling goddess who sends the thunderstorms. She gives showers of rain to all people and plants of the field to everyone. And Jeremiah 14:22, do any of the worthless idols of the nations bring rain? Do the skies themselves send down showers? No, it is you, ruling goddess. Therefore, our hope is in you. For you are the one who does all of this. But there is no one outside of you. It's you. So you're being called to wake up to your pure love. And you are the chosen one. And with that, we're going to move on with a little poem from Fiona Kurds called Magicians. Whenever you're ready.
Righty-ho. Magicians. Image in imagination, it's all visualization. All you hope to find starts off in the mind. It's the spark of creation. Do you really need some proof? Open eyes to see the truth. Look around the place, objects in the space, hatched ideas under the roof. What you believe in creates your reality. Is it uncouth or imbued with morality? Fight or flight, dark or light, extremes in this realm of duality. Internal speech, a useful tool, not taught this in any school. Reprogram your mind and kindness you'll find, for love is the only rule. Love is a verb, not a feeling. It's the catalyst to your receiving. Remove indecision, power up your vision with all things you find appealing.
Awesome.